Hi everyone, welcome to our Japan vlog where we went through 6 cities in 10 days. And our first flight was to Tokyo and it was a midnight flight. It lasted about 7 plus hours and it cost about $700 each for a round trip. So we took Scoot there and then we took Zip Air back. The flight there was pretty okay, but by the time we reached it was early in the morning, so we were really tired and hungry. We made our way to the train towards the city. And from there, we wanted to drop our bags before we go for an early brunch. Our first hotel was a budget hotel because we wanted to save some money on our first night.
So now we're going to get our Ichiran Ramen lunch, which is a 5-minute walk away from the hotel.
So this is actually my first time eating Ichiran Ramen in person, so it was really exciting for me because previously I've only tried the packet ramen, but being here in person in the squeezy cubicle and hearing the sounds and getting served through the panel was just a very good experience.
So check out my vlogging setup.
So now we're on the way to the Me Pig Cafe, which shows micro pigs, and I was searching up for things to do. I found this was quite interesting, but they didn't allow us to take videos for YouTube, so it was quite an interesting experience to say the least. I didn't expect some of the pigs to be so big, and they were also not as cute as I thought they would be. For tea, we found this really pretty cafe with a Christmas tree, and this was in December nearing Christmas, so it was a really nice ambiance to have. We checked in for a quick power nap and quickly left the place to go for a quick dinner. One of the main attractions in Tokyo is the Shibuya crossing, so we wanted to get a view of how busy this crossing was. We wanted to go to Amoido Yunosho, which is the bar alley area, and on the way we did some window shopping.
What is there? Not bad.
So this is the bar alley that's popular for its skewers and its drinks, and we were just looking and walking down to see which was the most popular restaurant. The atmosphere was really lively with many young people and office people coming here for drinks after their work. On the way home, we chanced on this super pretty scene and we went to the convenience store to grab some quick coffee and breakfast to get ready for our trip to the next city the next morning. So we wanted to go down to grab supper, but my boyfriend doesn't like to wear pants. So we went down like this and I'm sure the hotel guest downstairs got a huge shock. After this, we went for a quick soak in the hot spring and then went for a quick rest. And next morning, we were off to Hakone, which took about an hour plus. This scene was particularly scenic because we had the view of Mount Fuji and also some of the cultural sites. And just driving through the small towns really gave us a glimpse of how different parts of Japan looks like. On the way from lunch to our hotel, we chanced upon this super beautiful pampas field.
After a very long drive, we are finally at our hotel in Hakone. And this one is the room that I booked with a very nice view of Mount Fuji. So let's check out the room.
We didn't end up having the view of Mount Fuji, but I would say that this was one of my favorite hotels to stay at because of the private onsen.
This is the bed area.
And this is the dining area. And two kimonos. And then we have the private onsen over here. So you can enter. This is the shower area, and then after that you can go and soak inside. So this one is connected to the outdoor.
As much as we wanted to soak immediately, the sun sets about 4 plus, so we quickly ran out to see the pampas view. As it was already getting dark, we quickly grabbed some food from the convenience store and ate it in the room.
Good morning! Now we're off for our breakfast.
In Japan, the hotel breakfast starts and ends super early, so we had to wake up really early for this, and the food was not bad. And then we quickly came back to enjoy the onsen before leaving for the next city.
Day 2, and we're now leaving our really nice hotel in Hakone. So now we're going to take a 4-hour drive to Kyoto. See you in Kyoto.
This is one of our longer drives, and so I had to feed him many sweets so he wouldn't fall asleep. We had a bit of issues of parking with this hotel because we expected there to be free parking for the hotel guests, but we ended up having to park around the area, which was expensive because it was by the hour. The room was very well maintained and spacious for its price though, and because it's a budget hotel, we didn't have much expectations. By the time we reached, I was starving and I desperately needed coffee, so we went to the nearest cafe, and this had the best banana bread and coffee ever.
We're at the Rich Wine, and this guy didn't wear a mask, but you need a mask to go in, so...
Let's go wear that.
Yeah. Okay, let's go. It's actually very dark already. Like, this is how it actually looks like now. But on my camera, it looks brighter. Ooh, only made it red.
Looking back, we should have accounted for buffer time in our travelling and the fact that the sun set so early, because we ended up having to look at the attractions in the dark. We had a few recommendations to eat omakase at Thai Sushi, and we really enjoyed our time there because of how fresh the sushi was and how friendly the chef was.
We just pumped our petrol, and the petrol kiosk is quite cool because the pump is like dangling from the top and then they pull it down to pump. So now we have a full tank and we're going off to Arashiraya, the bamboo village. So show you that later.
Funny story, because when we drove in, the roads were full of soil and we didn't know where to park. So we actually accidentally drove into the bamboo village, and the visitors were all very shocked because we were squeezing through this walking passage over here. Overall, the atmosphere was really serene and peaceful, except for the fact that there were many tourists also walking around. There were many shrines around the area, but we went for Tenryu-ji, which was one of the more popular ones, but we found out that we had to pay to go in, so we only visited the outside.
Okay, now we are off to Nara Park. Yeah, let's go! 1 hour
ride!
Let's
go!
You guys are hoping. Okay.
Go! Wait. Help! Video me!
I didn't realize the deers to be so aggressive, and it was quite a scary experience because sometimes they could be pushing or pulling your clothing. But overall, they're still super cute, and they bow before taking the treats from you, so I guess that's pretty cute.
These are following us around the whole way. Hello. Oh, good boy.
Another attraction in Nara is also this mochi, which is just down along the market from the deer park. This is legit the softest and chewiest and tastiest mochi I've ever had. After walking around for a bit more, we left to return to Kyoto, and one thing was that the parking was super expensive. We really wanted to try Kobe beef, and since Kyoto was quite near to Kobe, we decided to have it here. And we were super hungry after that, so we decided to get teppanyaki because it was cheaper and could fill us up. This place was super wholesome and a direct contrast to the Kobe beef restaurant that we went to, which was more upscale. This one was full of tourists and just local Japanese people, and we really felt comfortable in eating the teppanyaki here. We had a really hearty dinner to last us through our night for our next morning towards Shirakawa-GO. It was so surreal being here because of the snow that we started to see on the trees on the way here, and the fact that this place was just so cold and so detached from the city life. I felt really unplugged over here, and just seeing the scenery with the mountains was just so surreal. So Shirakawa-GO is known for its thatched houses and has three small little villages, mostly full of tourists who are just trying out their popular Haida beef and the food and looking at their cultural sites.
You eat all the yolk, you eat all the yolk.
We had the best ever experience at this cafe called Rakujin, so I highly recommend that everyone who goes to Japan goes to Shirakawa-GO and goes to visit this cafe.
So this is the toilet. Shower area. Wow, looks pretty nice. And this is the room. Two beds and the sofa. Sofa bed. And check out the view. Wow.
Okay. This was actually Trevor's favorite hotel of the entire Japan trip. I think one point to note is that they made the entire hotel full of tatami, including the lifts, which was really cool. And the highlight to me is definitely the food. I feel that they fed us so much that I think we got back all our money that we paid for the hotel. The presentation of the food was top-notch, using the thatched roofs as an introduction to how they serve the food, as well as the variety of ingredients. For example, in Shirakawa-GO, they generally eat a lot of root vegetables, and this was seen in the meals.
We should ask them. Huh? We should ask them the sauce.
We are going for a hot spring now.
This time he decided to wear pants to the hot spring. And then the next morning we woke up to an amazing feast again, and we were so full from dinner the last night, so we could barely eat this. It was so difficult for us to part ways with this beautiful hotel and town.
Today is day 6 and we are leaving Shirakawa-GO. So now we are going to the Gusha village to walk around a little bit more, since our drive to Takayama is quite fast. And then after that, after we walk around for about 30 minutes, an hour, then after that we are going to Takayama.
It's a rainy day.
Take it.
We bought a ton of souvenirs from the stores around here because I really liked our time here. Takayama is also a very old and small town with a lot of cultural heritage.
This is the Haida folk village. Okay.
On the way to the Haida folk village, we were distracted by a bunch of cats and realized that there was a cat cafe there. So we ended up going in for about an hour. After some playtime with the cats, we are finally back on track on the itinerary to go to the Haida folk village.
We're at the Haida no Sato, Haida Folk Village. And this is the village.
Okay, now we're going in. We've just paid $7 each for admission. Let's go.
Even though it was $7 each, I think it's super worth it because of how well maintained the place is. They gave each of us a map and it was very easy for us to navigate around the entire village. And at each of the hut, we got to learn about a different cultural aspect of Takayama, such as marriages in Takayama or the way that they lived. And some of the activities were also quite interactive, such as buying the bread to feed the ducks, and we could bang the bell and pick up rocks. So I think that was quite an enriching and fun experience.
Why do you like this kind of thing?
Not fun, man.
After that, we went for a quick coffee break.
Aha!
So this is our hotel, cup of tea on Somme. And it's self-service, so we need to take this key. Okay, so we got room for 4 beds because they didn't have those with 2 beds alone. And it's kind of like a loft. So you have 2 beds over here at the below. And then you can take the stairs up and then there's another 2 beds here. So really nice, and the sofa and table.
The next morning we went to visit their markets where they were selling fresh food and also cooked food. It seemed like there were a couple of tourists over there as well. So this is just a compilation of all the food that we tried along the morning market, and we were so stuffed from all the food.
How's it? Is it sweet?
No, it is.
This was one of the highest rated restaurants in Takayama, and we couldn't get in the previous time, so we finally booked and got in early. I think the high rating is more to do with how good the service is, although the food was also really tasty. For dinner, we went to this tempura restaurant, which was okay. We had a super early night because our drive to Tokyo had to be very early in the morning. We had to return the car by afternoon. And we later took the train to the Muji Hotel where we would be staying for our last night in Ginza. We dropped off our luggages at the hotel and quickly went down to Tokyo Station to the Tokyo Ramen Street. So this has a whole street of ramen stores. After that, we conveniently took the train down to the Anime Street.
It's a meat cafe. Can I go?
I don't have.
We went into some anime stores where we looked at figurines, and it was quite interesting to me because I'm totally uninterested in these kind of things, but it was still fun to see. Back at our hotel, there was actually the largest Uniqlo and Muji store, and the entire building was just full of Uniqlo clothes. So I got a bag there customized with my cat's face, and then we lugged some of the items back into the Muji hotel where we could finally check in. Even though this was quite expensive at about 300 SGD for one night, I thought it was super worth it because I'm a diehard Muji fan and I really wanted to visit Tokyo so that I could stay here.
Oh my god.
Okay, this is the kettle, humidifier, this is the coffee machine, capsules over here.
Visiting the 6-story Muji store right downstairs our hotel was an attraction in itself. I love seeing all the other products that they had that Singapore didn't have, and at their ground floor they even had a bakery.
I think our yakiniku like, and I just lit up the fire.
What do you lit up?
You press A and B. You press your side A and B. Press both at the same time, A and B at the same time, for 2 seconds.
fire. It says on the screen.
Because we were so broke from our shopping, we decided that we could only afford to eat yakiniku light for our next two meals. So we came here for dinner, and then the next morning, our last meal, we headed over here as well. Overall, we had a really great time in Japan and can't wait to be back.